182.4 this AM, so already back to my normal weight just by, you know, dieting normally 2 days after cheating. I am a little tired because I didn't have my coffee yet, but I'm going to show you guys meal one that we're doing right here. Starting this AM off with 2 scoops of ISO 100, 2 cups of almond milk, and some coconut oil for good fats. Blend that up. As you see, we got the shake right here, rest of it in the blender. As you also see, no furniture in my house right now because we're getting all new furniture. So everything is sort of just barren and empty. But gonna enjoy this one. We got these egg whites cooking. A few other things to add to this meal. I'll show you this meal when it's all finished. Whoa. Stuff this egg white omelet with green beans, and there's actually more in the middle. Some of them did fall out, as you see. I don't know about you guys, but with my egg whites, I always like to get it a little crispy on the sides. Makes it a little bit better. And we need some fats for this meal, so I'm gonna get some maple almond butter by Justin's. Trying to take the Christmas lights off of this Christmas tree, or artificial tree, I should say, and it's really hell, because my sister put them on, and they're just a complete tangled mess. So, I don't know how long this is going to take. Probably a decent amount of time. Decided I'm going to hit the gym now, because I want to beat that rush, that crowd. So, I had 2 meals so far. If I knew I was going to hit the gym early today, what I would have done was just make one of my carb meals pre-workout, but I didn't really plan ahead too well. So we're just gonna have our carb meals all post-workout, but I'm gonna get my pre-workout in right now. You already know what I'm taking. Where's it at? Here it is. Hyde cotton candy for the win, and I'll probably throw in a little bit of BCAAs as well, just for the hell of it. Oh, also creatine. Forgot to take this yesterday. I can tell. I can tell, baby, I can tell. Ooh, I can tell, baby, I can tell. You ain't told no tales, you ain't told no tales. Yeah, no, 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 man, you know I can tell. Yeah, I can tell, baby, I can tell. I can tell, baby, I can tell. I can tell. First lift of this new week, guys, we're hitting barbell bench, barbell deadlifts, and hamstring work. I also hit abs, and yes, that is a little bit of a new split. As I mentioned the past few videos, we're hopping on something new, and I'm going to try it out and see how it goes. So far, honestly, I love it, because this bench press workout was probably the best lift as far as bench press goes I've had in the past month. As you know, during my bulk, I was hitting 285 for 4 reps, and then it went down a little bit when I started cutting, but I was able to push up 275 for 5 reps, and then on the second set here, I got 275 for 4 reps, and they were grinders, but as you know, when I bench heavy, I do grind it a little bit, and then on these last 3 sets of bench, I got 225 for 3 total sets of 10. That felt so smooth. I was actually stopping myself at 10 reps. I'm confident I could have gotten 11 or 12 on the first set, and honestly, as the sets went on, they kind of just got smoother, the reps. I was taking, you know, 3 to 5 minute rest periods, but my endurance was really there for these higher rep sessions. As you see, I put the rest of the 225 sets into double speed just for time's sake. But as far as this day goes, hitting something like bench press and then switching it up and not doing any more upper body work and just doing hamstrings and stuff, I like it so far. I like the style, and I think I'm going to enjoy it a lot more. As you know, deadlifts, they've never been something that I've really religiously practiced. I'm not even really that great at them. I just try to keep my form as tight as possible. I try to keep it relatively light. I do like to play around a little bit heavier weight, heavier for me at least, obviously not heavier in the grand scheme of things. But I definitely want to get better at these guys. I'm going to be honest, I neglected them in my bulk. We all know I made like pretty solid gains in my bulk, but if I did deadlifts, I probably would have put on a lot more, got a lot more back development than I actually obtained. But you can't complain about it now. I'm going to throw deadlifts in, and I'm going to see what they can give me. Honestly, they're one of the most beneficial movements. So if you're neglecting them, it's just kind of stupid. If you're healthy for a movement, especially compound movement, and it feels good, and it doesn't cause any injury for you, and you're doing it right, then you should 100% do it all the time. So as you see, this is my heaviest set here, 315. I can't say it was smart to go up to 315. I've hit it before. I've hit it touch and go, but I was resetting after each rep here, and I don't have straps on. And believe it or not, a lot of people say arms are my strong point, but my grip does fail on deadlifts just because it's not a movement I'm too used to. But all in all, these felt really good on my hamstrings and glutes, and obviously there's back engagement as well. So I like this day how I go from bench press to deadlifts. You might think that's sort of powerlifter style, but the split I'm on is really geared towards building muscle and getting sufficient volume for bodybuilding type results. And I am still keeping my reps in the higher range to get sufficient volume. So I am still focused towards building muscle on top of the strength gains that are going to come with hitting these compounds. So 275 is what I dropped down to for my second to last set. I believe I hit 275 for about 6 reps. And after this, I dropped all the way back down to 225. And I was able to get a decent amount with that. And all in all, felt really good. So stay tuned for the rest of the video, guys. I'm going to have to go film the rest of the video, show you guys the rest of my meals. And I will catch you in the next one. Enjoy. All right, guys, really solid workout in there today. Barbell bench, barbell deadlift, and then hamstring accessory. Felt awesome. Killed abs as well. And I'm just gonna drink all this water right now because I really need to get some water in. I need to find my car. Here's my car. And I have to go home and get in 50 carbs, 50 protein, no fat. So let's go hit that. I'm gonna do 52 grams of this ISO whey right here, which is giving me 50 protein. And then I don't have my dextrose in yet. I did order some, and I need carbs, like I said. So I'm just gonna go with 4.5 of these rice cakes. Each of them is 11 carbs, so that'll be right around 50. And that's gonna be the meal. Let's blend this up. All right, guys, here's the post-workout meal. We got the whey, we got the rice cakes. 50 protein, 50 carb. Still no table, as you see. Getting the new furniture in the house pretty soon, I guess, but not yet. So this is how we're doing it. Pour this shake in here. Oh, that looks solid. I'm going through a lot of this ISO whey, guys. So I did order a 5-pound tub, I think it is, or 4. Their largest tub I ordered. Dimetized ISO whey, it's like my go-to whey right now. As far as flavor profile, I just like it the best. I ordered fudge brownie, which I haven't had yet, but I heard it's really good. And this is birthday cake, so check out that brand if you haven't yet. Just finished up the voiceover portion of this video, as you see, for the workout footage. And it is that time again for a meal. So I have 2 carb meals left. This next meal is gonna be carb, protein, veggie, and let's cook it and show you guys what I have. Next meal in preparation. Little Italian medley, Mrs. Dash. All right, guys, meal 4 going down at 6:03 p.m. This is my second post-workout meal. It's a carb, protein, veggie meal. We got 50 carbs from the cream of wheat right here. That's correct, cream of wheat. Thought it was cream of rice for a second, but it's not. And I sweeten the cream of wheat with cinnamon and Splenda. And I just have chicken breast, green beans, and I have some Mrs. Dash garlic on there with some more water because you can never get enough.
Time to crush this, guys. Meal 5 about to go in the books. Put it in the light so you can see it a little better. Have a nice 8-ounce sweet potato with some turkey and broccoli. Saute it up, cook together, Mrs. Dash seasoning. Yet another water to crush.
Your picture's gonna be on this shirt soon.
I know, I would feel better if Lenny got a good paddling and ass fucking.
A lot of mints in this latest Misfits video, but I just finished up meal 5, as you see. So what I'm gonna do now is make meal 6, put it in the fridge, and show you guys what it is now, so that way I can get this video edited up, and eat meal 6 after I shower, most likely. And then just head to bed, because if I wait to include that clip later, then I won't be able to edit the video in time. So let's get meal 6 together. I'll show you guys what it is. So in this bowl, we have right around 2 scoops of this casein protein. And what I'm gonna add to that is just Justin's maple almond butter for some good healthy fats. And I'll show you what that looks like mixed up. There we go, guys, meal 6. Casein protein, almond butter. Now that I got the almond butter mixed in there, I'm just gonna throw it in the fridge, right up here. Close that and eat it after my shower. So, if you enjoyed this video, guys, throw it a thumbs up. Follow me along on my future journey to getting lean, because we are gonna get lean, and it's gonna be pretty dope. And go ahead and drop a comment, drop a like, subscribe if you haven't already, follow me on Instagram. Until that next video, guys, I will see you then. Peace out.